Hello, I am Akram Jafar, and in today's session, we will be exploring practical histology of the lymphatic system through picture-based tests. This video serves as both a valuable revision resource and a self-assessment tool. To utilize it for self-assessment, feel free to pause the video, take some time to ponder the questions, and formulate your answers. Afterward, you can replay the video to verify your responses by listening to the accompanying commentary and explanations. Which of the following structures is a primary lymphoid tissue? Let's first of all find the definition of a primary lymphatic organ. A primary lymphatic organ provides an environment for stem cells to divide and mature into B and T lymphocytes. The red bone marrow gives rise to mature B cells, while the thymus gland is the site where pre-T cells from red bone marrow mature. So a primary lymphatic organ is either a bone marrow or the thymus. A secondary lymphatic organ, on the other hand, is the site where most immune responses occur. Secondary lymphatic organs can be either encapsulated, like lymph nodes. One of them is shown here in one. Look at the capsule of connective tissue, dense irregular connective tissue, the bean shape of the lymph node, the presence of a cortex and a medulla, and above all, the presence of lymphatic nodules in the cortex. So one is a lymph node, and it's not a primary lymphatic organ. It is the site where immune responses occur, where lymphocytes multiply, but they have already reached maturity. A secondary lymphatic organ is not always surrounded by a capsule of connective tissue, but sometimes it is non-encapsulated, like lymphatic nodules, which are shown here in three. The lymphatic nodules are located underneath the mucosa, hence they are called mucosal-associated lymphoid tissue, or MALT. If you look closely at the section in three, it shows lymphatic nodules with light staining germinal center, but the entire tissue is not surrounded by a connective tissue capsule. It is covered by non-keratinizing stratified squamous epithelium. The aggregates of lymphatic nodules under the epithelium also show the presence of crypts like these, indicating the tissue is derived from tonsils in the pharynx. So three is again a secondary lymphatic organ that is non-encapsulated. We are looking for a primary lymphatic tissue. If you look at slide two, it shows a lobulated organ invested by a fibrous capsule from which short interlobular septa, the septa radiate from the capsule of connective tissue. Also, you can see a dark staining outer cortex and a lighter staining inner medulla. Look at the cortex. The cortex does not show lymphoid follicles like the one that are shown here in a lymph node. So, two is not a lymph node. It is the thymus, which is a primary lymphatic organ where maturation of T lymphocytes takes place from lymphocytes derived from bone marrow. Therefore, the correct answer here is C, two only. Which of the following locations is the main site of removal of worn-out RBCs? Removal of worn-out erythrocytes from the blood primarily takes place by macrophages of the splenic cords. The slide on the left shows an encapsulated lymphatic organ. Look at the capsule of connective tissue and note the presence of a cortex and a medulla. Also note the presence of lymphatic nodules like these in the cortex with a clear germinal center. So this slide with its two locations, two and one, is not the main site of removal of worn out RBCs. It's a lymph node. The middle slide here, where three is located, shows another encapsulated lymphoid organ. You can see the capsule here. This organ has a darkly staining packed cortex and a lighter staining lens densely packed
medulla. The medulla also shows a particular feature of the thymus, the thymic Hassall corpuscles. These are concentrically lamellated structures. The lamellated corpuscles represent masses of degenerating epithelial cells that incorporate macrophages containing debris from degenerate cortical lymphocytes. Now, this confirms that area 3 belongs to the thymus and it is not related to the removal of worn-out RBCs. The slide on the right shows trabeculae of connective tissue. You can see it here. This is a trabecula. This is another trabecula. Here is another trabecula. These trabeculae are extending into the parenchyma of two distinct areas, a white pulp and a red pulp. The white pulp consists of lymphoid aggregations, like in 5, and a red pulp in 4. There's no cortex and medulla, like in the thymus or in the lymph nodes. Thus, the slide here on the right represents a spleen. Also note that the lymphatic aggregates in 5, the white pulp, are located around central arteries, here, here, here as well. This is another feature confirming the histology of a spleen. The red pulp in 4 is called so because it is highly vascular. It contains splenic cords and venous sinuses. The splenic cords consist of reticular tissue rich in macrophages, plasma cells, blood cells, and lymphocytes. The blood cells enter the red pulp from the central arteries and squeeze through the walls of the sinuses that are present in the red pulp to drain out of the spleen. While doing so, worn-out erythrocytes are removed from the blood by macrophages of the splenic cords found in the red pulp 4. Which of the following structures is also considered an endocrine organ? One is a lymph node. Note the fibrous tissue capsule and the surrounding adipose tissue. Don't confuse this with a thymus. This is a lymph node with a cortex and medulla. Here you can see it shows medullary cords and medullary sinuses. And although a cortex and medulla is also shown in slide 2, which is a thymus, the cortex of the lymph node is not like the cortex of the thymus. The cortex of the lymph node has nodules, lymphatic nodules. Also, the medulla, which shows medullary cords and medullary sinuses, lacks the Hassall's corpuscles or the lamellated corpuscles, like these, which characterize the medulla of the thymus. These lamellated structures represent masses of degenerating epithelial cells that incorporate macrophages containing debris from degenerate cortical lymphocytes. So slide 1 is a lymph node, and while the term lymph gland may have been used historically to describe these structures, the term lymph node is the preferred and more accurate term used in temporary medical terminology, since the lymph node has no secretion and so it is not a gland. Now, returning to slide 2, slide 2, as I said, is the thymus. So let's identify slide 3 before jumping into the answer. The slide on the right shows a red pulp and a white pulp. There's no cortex or medulla, thus the slide represents a spleen. Also note that the lymphatic aggregates in the spleen also show a central artery. This is another feature confirming the histology of a spleen, the lymphatic aggregates around central arteries. Now, returning to the question, which of the following structures is also considered an endocrine gland? The thymus, which is a primary lymphatic organ for T-cell maturation, is also considered an endocrine gland because of its secretion of hormones that regulate T-cell maturation within the thymus. The epithelial reticular cells that have fine cytoplasmic extensions and form a stromal meshwork also produce thymic hormones that aid in T-cell maturation. Remember that these same epithelial reticular cells also form the blood-thymus barrier by forming sheets around the blood vessels, creating a barrier to the entry of antigenic material to the thymic parenchyma. Thus, the correct answer here is the thymus, which is also considered an endocrine gland. Which of the following structures is considered a filter for blood? If you look at slide 1, this is a lymph node. You can see the fibrous capsule here, some fatty tissue surrounding it. And this lymph node is characterized by a cortex and medulla. These are trabeculae of connective tissue. This is the medulla with the medullary cords and medullary sinuses. Note that the cortex has lymphatic nodules, aggregates of lymphoid tissue. Some of them are showing a germinal center. These are secondary nodules or active nodules. And it is actually the lymph node which is a filter for lymph, not for blood. It receives multiple afferent lymphatic vessels and give rise to one or two efferent lymphatic vessels. Thus, lymphocytes in the lymph node are exposed to antigens in lymph as it flows through the node from afferent to efferent lymphatic vessels. Slide 2 shows a parenchyma of an organ with two distinct areas, a white pulp and a red pulp. There is no cortex and medulla. Thus, the slide represents a spleen. Also note that the lymphatic aggregates are located around central arteries, which is a characteristic feature of the spleen, the white pulp of the spleen. The splenic red pulp is highly vascular. Hence, it's called the red pulp. Blood cells enter the red pulp from the capillaries originating from these central arteries and squeeze through the walls of venous sinuses that are present in the red pulp to drain out of the spleen. This renders the spleen a filter for blood. Immunological reactions can take place to antigens in the blood, so as the removal of worn out red blood cells from the blood by macrophages of the splenic cords, the defective cells being less deformable and thus unable to negotiate through the narrow slits of the basement membrane of the sinusoidal basement membrane. So the correct answer here is 2. The spleen is the structure that is considered a filter of blood. Now let's identify slide 3 just to confirm the answer. 3 is showing aggregates of lymphoid tissue, but these aggregates are not surrounded by a capsule of connective tissue. They are covered by mucous membrane. This mucous membrane is stratified squamous epithelium, non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. So this is what we call the MALT, mucosa-associated lymphoid tissue, that is aggregated. You can see that underneath the mucosa, there are sections of muscle fibers, as well as some mucous acini, which are shown here. These represent accessory salivary glands. This section is therefore in the tongue, and these are the muscle fibers in the tongue, actually the posterior third of the tongue, where the lingual tonsil is located. So this lymphoid tissue here does not act as a filter for the blood. Actually, it acts against antigens that enter through the beginning of the respiratory and digestive passages. The correct answer here is the spleen that acts as a filter of blood.